You know what it is? It's Listening Party, Link Up TV. It's Aaron Roach Bridgman. Big up Arnold George, couldn't make it today, so I'm temporarily stepping in. Today we got Mo Stack Stacko. First of all, before we start, any Mo Stack fans in the building?
Yes, close, 100%. Yeah. 100%.
All right, boom.
10 out of 10 already.
10 out of 10 already. All right, look, boom, let's get straight into it.
Mo Stack is very creative. I think he's a great character. I love his banter, I love his energy.
You wanna come when I'm having a juice? But sorry, brother, you ain't gang enough. And the price for this Canada goose. Cost more than a flight out to Canada. Jeez. No blood spilling. Bro, are you kidding? He didn't have it in them off the hard that talk.
Jeez. A few days and everyone knows the bars already.
Cold.
You know what it is? Mo Stack like this is perfection. Yeah. That flow, that beat.
Mo Stack is incredible. I actually have so much love and respect for him as an artist. I think he's so sick. I think he's so versatile with his flow. He's just effortless. He's actually effortless.
Blood, I'm a psycho, I mean it. Don't take a leaf out of my book. Why? Because I class that as feeling. You're not way too certain. I'm a red the block in my 30s. Bunning them by myself just to act like it weren't me.
Gang shit.
He
can go on any sort of tune and it's not gonna sound like pain. Do you get what I'm saying? He's like that excitement, fun, party. Yeah, he's got character. A lot of these rappers ain't got no character.
That's what I like about him, because a lot of these artists out here ain't got no character. You can feel it in their music, you can hear when they talk. He's got a lot of character.
No, it is. Suppose it was sec. Mo makes bare good vibes music still. Bare good vibes music.
You can chill on a beach and or walk on a beach up and down, listening to Mo. He gives you that vibe.
I'm not putting myself out there, but I feel I used to do that, like make people smile.
No, I'm dead serious. He makes me smile when I listen to him, and I like that. Like, there's no aggression. Like, even when he brings in a bit of aggression to it, you smile through it.
He doesn't force it. Like, it's just him.
It's just saying, and you can hear it in the lyrics. I'm gangster. Don't play with me.
And he's not neaky. Like, he's not neaky, but he's.
Let me get back to Shannon.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Hey, hold tight, Shannon.
Shannon. All the way in Cardiff as well. Got more travelling.
Next one, for me, I think it's the best track on the album. The next one is called Stinking Rich, featuring Dave and Jay Huss.
You expect to hear a Jay Huss on there, expect to hear a Dave, and he gave that to us, and I loved it.
Arm and a leg.
This is the Dave I like, by the way. Yes. This is the Dave I like.
Don't say that. Yeah. Don't look at me when you say that.
Mark, I know you agree. Because this is the Dave we want. This Dave, the Fredo Dave, Dave. Yeah? The one I can add to the playlist.
I needed that kind of Dave from him on the album. I needed the Dave and Fredo kind of flex there.
Hey, just think about when you're at a party, yeah? Man likes songs that they can show off to. Man likes songs that they can flex to. So I'm stinking rich. You feel like you're in your own wave. You can diss all the hoes that want you for the money. You can diss the hoes that are trying to come to your table because you're stinking rich. So like, man will get gas. Like even men that don't have money, you just get gas. You wanna live through them, do you get it? So even me, like I'm not stinking rich, but through this song, you just have the energy when you're out.
I ain't even got peas like that, but this tune is making me enjoy life a little bit more, you feel me?
Dave on that track comes with a lot of puns. He's obviously talking about certain things that he might not be talking about in all the songs on his album. So I think she wants a bit of grit, she wants a bit of hood, a bit of road, I get it. But I can appreciate that side of Dave as well as the deeper things that he discusses in his album. So I don't know if I get her, I just think it's another thing to love about Dave.
Jay Huss can say anything, he doesn't have to make sense, but because of his flow and just how he comes effortless on it, we'll take it all.
I'm just glad that this is a nice little package of these three on there. Like, this is perfect.
Oh, it's so nice.
This is so perfect.
When I saw the lineup, I knew it was a good game.
Nobody came weak. Nobody was weak for me. Everyone stood out.
And I think that's what we need more of. It shows that unity, it shows that elevation. Everyone's going to be on their A game if they're going to be on a track like that together. So I really like that song.
Oh God, it just makes me want to smile already. Just makes me want to smile. Do you know what I mean? It does, it does. Come on.
It makes me want to be at a pool party and just like living, barbecue, good time. Yeah. Barbecue, good time.
I'm not going to lie, he's got a barbecue playlist, man.
Yeah, barbecue playlist.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the flow on a few of the tracks, and I think because it came like back to back to back, they were like similar, like in a row.
Let me say something. I like this song, yeah, but let me just throw it all the drama onto my mate, as Mark said. It sounds like I just do what I wanna. It sounds a bit similar. I like the vibe of the song. But it sounds like the other one, that's what I was saying.
Okay. It sounds like the do what I want, I want, I want to tune, but... Now it's a nice vibe again, man. Yeah, same formula, innit? You knew
there's
what he was
doing.
There's
still something special about it. I love
yeah,
the little
definitely.
Guitar bit.
Nice
it makes
tune,
you wanna,
man.
It's a man, barbecue song.
A man might have a formula, but it's a formula that's winning.
I'm not saying it's a bad formula. You're not going to get me killed by rappers and drillers, bro, week after week. I already got drillers after me, bro.
The songs were similar in the fact that they make you want to do a certain thing. They want to be at a barbecue. They want to make you have fun. And if that's the thing that's the same within every single song, then that's the perfect thing to be the same. The bars weren't the same, the flows weren't the same, the beat weren't the same. Oh, I'm upset that all the songs made me want to have fun.
I just love the fact that he says the word vagina. Vagina sounds like a respectful word as well.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, I don't you respect the vagina.
You look vexed though. Do you like the vagina thing as well? What are you telling me? You look vexed though. I don't know if you're feeling it as well.
She's a drill girl, you know? Ooh, I want to hear boom, boom.
I just don't think it's a big deal.
No, but you like hearing it in the songs, in music? You like hearing it?
I don't care.
You don't care?
She's too friendly. I feel like I'm waiting for something new though. Like, I think the next song needs to hit different though. I think every pool party, barbecue, you know, like that, this is going to be played. However though, we're almost halfway with the project and I want to hear something different, if that makes sense.
He provides that fun and entertainment element towards music and whatnot, and you can carry the energy that he puts on the track anywhere.
This is a little twerk.
Nah, I don't like it. I don't think I like it though. I was saying I don't think I like that. Take them. I don't like repetition that much in a chorus. Take them down, down. Boom, 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 boom,
man,
boom.
That was a let that run. That sounded all right still.
Really?
I'm not gonna lie. If that was played that wireless, it will
be. I'm trying to hear that.
This sounds like a twerking anthem, so I'm here for it.
Let me hear that. Let me hear
that. That bit's sick. Hey. Yeah, this bit's lit.
I don't think it's lit.
Okay, no. I think it's lit.
I think it will
the melody in the verses is lit.
Yeah, I'm done. I can hear the next one now. You don't think this is cool? Huh? You don't like this?
One at a time. The flow was very slow, yeah. It's like the beat was going boom, 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 and he wasn't going boom, boom, boom with the beat. He was going...
I think this is cold still. I think this is cold. This is one of the better. It's just a different kind of mole, you feel me?
Yeah.
It's still mole, but it's a different kind of...
Me personally, having listened to the whole song, I like his flow on the verses, yeah? The verses are sick, like the melody, like it's kind of nursery rhyme, I like that. But the chorus isn't strong enough, man. I just feel like it's a bit... that repetitive is a bit cringe.
Yeah, if I was in the car, I would have skipped this.
I think these songs are the songs that will bug in crowds.
One minute.
They know crowds. Like, I think what they're trying to do is cater to a crowd. So if you go to a festival, like you said, it's summer.
I was kind of thinking, I don't really know a man that wouldn't fuck with this. So that's a big thumbs up to him. He done very, very well there.
As a man from Northwest, I want to hear a gunshot on a tune sometime.
You are a man from Northwest.
Is he in me? Bow! It sounds all right. I'm not saying I'm shooting. Put it on the rhythm, innit?
I would have wanted a bit more. You know what I'm trying to say? A bit more on a hip-hop thing. Give me some pain. You know, like one of them tracks, a story track. Let me know what you've been going through and let me know how you felt when them man took your jewels and thing and stuff that's going on with your family and thing. Open up a bit more. Let me get to know you a bit. But that's just the lyricist in me and, like, you know what I'm trying to say?
If you don't like it, go home and twerk to it and you'll see that you like it.
Hey, I'm done with it. I'm done.
So far. There is definitely something for everyone on this album. Unless you're someone that loves like a lot of violence.
I'm not gonna lie, yeah. I really like Stormzy a lot, but I think them
not
two
on this song.
Thank you. They could have made a better song than
I'll say
this,
it.
Man.
I'll say it because they have to be a bit afraid to. Yeah. I don't like. I no, because I've heard it. So I'm not gonna sit here and front like I ain't heard it.
No, I ain't heard it. I ain't heard it.
All right, listen then. Listen to it then. I'll talk to you after. I'll still be here.
I can't complain about any of the features on there apart from Stormzy's one. I expected a better track, to be honest.
I like hearing Stormzy go crazy. Do you get what I'm saying?
So what you're saying is you feel like he maybe didn't fit on that tune, so who would be better on it? Would Notes be better on that tune? Who would be better on it?
Probably. Yeah. I'm glad you said that, because you think that, but you want me to put it out. Yeah, as he said, Notes would be. Between Mos Def and Stormzy, I think they could have created a more upbeat song. Do you get what I'm saying? A more, I don't know, man. Like, yeah, I don't see you as the two guys that are in love telling girls that you want them to shine.
Of course, Stormzy.
No, but I don't, bro.
Of course he is.
You better have some fucking respect for Stormzy's relationship, brother.
Hey.
Bro, okay, cool. There's certain men in relationships and get all lovey-dovey. That's me. There's men that get gorilla-ish in their relationship. That's Stormzy. Like, I want to hear you tell him, man.
He loves his girl.
He loves his girl, but he doesn't love her. Not in the open, though. Like, do you get what I'm saying?
No, but it is the open. It is in the open, my bro.
No, listen to what I'm saying.
It is in the open.
They're cutting me. They're cutting me.
I respect your relationship, but man don't like the song.
You lot are making that. I'm not talking about a man's relationship. I'm just talking about the character that he is. Yeah, in public, bro. In public.
He makes the love known in public.
No, but you prefer to hear
him. I'm talking about him musically, bro. I'm not saying he's a gorilla like he's battering his gal in the yard.
He's not a gorilla.
You lot are making me seem like he's beating up Maya Jama in the crib.
He's a musical gorilla. Wait.
Yeah.
He done a song before, that happy birthday thing for her.
That's what I'm saying. I didn't like that.
First of all, we should make it very clear that he's not calling Stormzy a gorilla. He's just talking about it in terms of the energy and the vibe of the song. It's down to personal preference. I mean, if you like the more crud Stormzy, then obviously, cool, you'd like him to come a bit more on gorilla mode. But then if you love the sweet Stormzy, then you don't mind it.
Okay, this rhetoric that you're pushing here is fine for someone that is only constricted to one genre. Listen to the melodies, bro. Listen to the hook. Listen to what he's doing. As you expect, no, because you're not deep in it. As someone that you expect to be a rapper, and now they're coming as a singer, you have to think about the writing. You have to take it into consideration, bro. It's sick.
Some of us don't check all that deepness of a situation.
But you can hear it. You can hear it, though.
But let me say something, though. So do you feel like only certain artists should do them kind of tracks? That's what
sounds
like to me, though.
No. But listen to what I'm just saying. For that track, it didn't suit Stormzy. Someone back me up and stop making me jump into the river.
It don't suit Stormzy. Stormzy's a gorilla.
I'm talking about musically. He's a musical gorilla. So when I hear him, he's a savage.
I know what you mean. I'm not talking racially. I've heard man go, oh no, I'm blinded by your grace, your grace. That's what he's done. And so is he a gorilla on that?
No.
No, you weren't. I loved him on that. I loved him on that. But that makes you want to go church.
You came and saved me.
Go on, anyway.
And then you want to hear him.
How can you not say that a man did blinded by your grace, but you can't expect him to do this? That's ridiculous.
Let me say that.
Because Stormzy. Yes, but we already know that there's more to his caliber.
One at a time, please.
What's the argument? This is just, you lot are saying you don't want to hear Stormzy singing about gyal.
I didn't say that.
No, let me go.
They could have done a better song together.
I hear that, but everyone could do a better tune. Listen, you expect that. If I hear I expected to hear them kind of tune. Stormzy, I just want to hear a nice thing. I know it's going to be a nice little vibe with Mos Def. What do you want them to talk about?
Did you like it?
I liked it. I hear what you're saying. It could be a bit better because it's Stormzy and you want it
to be. Stormzy telling man, shut up and go into number one. That's what I want, bro.
He's giving man.
I don't feel different. I've heard the song.
Man said, like, you want to hear Stormzy talking about
and all I'm just saying, it's a bit like, you know, like, I love the way you shine, girl. It's a bit like,
I don't understand.
Yeah, bro, it's a bit like that. Come on, bro.
I don't think everybody has to like the song, but I just don't like hearing that limiting an artist. Do you know what I mean?
I'm not limiting Stormzy, because his listing is all over the place.
Yeah, so let me, now everyone's not here, let me say that. I don't want to hear, like, Stormzy's good like that, but I don't want to hear Stormzy like that. Stormzy, it's like me hearing 50 Cent. Like, I want to hear 50 Cent, he can do his 21 questions, but I prefer 50 Cent on I Get Money, because that's more 50 Cent. So Stormzy, the Vossy Bop, the Shut Up, the other one, the other banger that he had, I want to hear him like that. Hearing him like on, maybe it was not so bad, it was just a shock to my system to hear him like that. That's the best way I could say it. But come on, man, you can't doubt Stormzy, man. He's the coldest, like.
I'm the one that's marked out. Two man guard up, three man brother, fucking farmer, five on roller. Six man band up, seven man get jealous, they get eight like jello.
Hey.
He's a five.
Yes. How's he moving from this track to the last track? And you liked the last one, didn't you, boys? My friend. Stop it now. My friend. You better stop this now. My friend. Banger after banger.
Hey.
This is what I'm saying. This is, and you know what? This is the reaction when you like something. Not just saying, you know, I like Shine Girl. Don't just say it with your chest, bro. Because I say I don't like it with my chest. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. Like, no, it's the black to black thing. The back to back thing sounding. Yeah.
Yes, sounds cold.
Right now.
Already.
Tape needed is still like a little different. A little something different to come in. This is the right time still.
Everyone that he's featured on the track, it's like a back to back on every single track. It's like they have their verse. They have, exactly. He's not done like, okay, I'm just going to.
Yeah, and this track is definitely suited to Fredo. Like, this 100%. Is Fredo's kind of production as well.
And they're world class features.
When you're on a Mostat track, you know exactly what type of vibe or flow to go with, because you know what type of artist he is already.
Listen,
that's my favourite bar of the whole album so far. That's my favourite bar of the whole album so far. What? He said Gad told him it's his time in a month, so he turned his whip round because he ain't got time for no hugs. Gang shit.
That is so rude.
That's real life shit. Big up yourself, Fredo, man. That was cold still. I'm not even going to lie. That was one of my favourite tunes on the tape still. The back-to-back vibe and the beat and all that. When I go home, I'm going to put it in the car and take it in and listen to it properly. But yeah, nah, that sounded big still.
Pause this one sec.
You know what I rate you? Because you got bare things. Bare things, man. You got bare things. Play, let me hear about the rest of it.
I heard Asian, I heard Croydon.
What?
Different locations, different
places. What are you talking about? Nifa Bun and Gadford Breed, and that was set.
He didn't really blow no one up, when you think about it.
I think a lot of people were quite sketchy about it. I didn't really think there was nothing wrong with it, you know. I think Ho should get exposed. Do you know what I mean? Like, yeah, I don't think there were the ones that weren't hoes he spoke very highly of, so you know, it is where it is.
This is a good album still. This is a very good album. This is a very good album. I can't see a tune that's I can't. I ain't heard a tune that's less than a 7.5.
Hey, what I'm telling you now, this is what I was getting at. You see, it's a listening party thing. Pure vibes.
Nah, that's
this,
what, I'm saying, it's vibes. It's
just because it's taking the whole thing.
I think why everyone's just loving it as well, because his bars are so relatable. He's not doing too much. He's not stretching with anything.
He's not saying the mad thing. He's not stunting on no one. He's just talking about things we can do.
Very honest. 100%.
He's himself.
And it's authentic. It's such authentic music, and I think that's why people relate to it a lot more and just vibe to it as well, because it's feel good music.
A man said, "If I bring you some love, don't run from me or don't hide from me." That's real. Aww. That's real.
Obviously, I've heard all these singles that he's put out there, and they've all been dope, and the little verses that he's put out there. But hearing a man back to back is so different, and not getting bored of him, and you kind of want to hear what he's saying.
Most Stack does sound similar at some points because he has a very particular style. His production is a massive part of that. I think maybe about track 5 or 6, just kind of early on, there was a point when it did sound a bit similar, but then it picked up again because we had new features, we had different production, and of course the content changed as well.
He saved it for me. And I wasn't feeling that at first, but...
It sounds like something
he
used to play or something.
I don't like it. I'm going to put it out there. No, they're going to go around the bushes. I don't like it, and you don't.
They just have this on in the whip, in the gym. What's wrong with it?
No, this ain't gym music.
What's wrong with it?
I don't know what you're pushing in the gym
these
for that tune, bro.
These lot just want to hear about men getting shot. I want to hear a Gareth gym sometime.
It's not really a gym song, come on, bro.
What are you pushing in that song? 20s? What are you doing? 20s.
Cardio, cunts.
Yoga.
Man said Pilates. I'm in it.
I think that's where he tried to go out the box and cater for other people.
I respect your reason, but I didn't get it.
You know, I'm a house raver. Yeah, I don't want to go into a house raver and hear Mo Stack. I think I'm buzzing out my nut. I'll be like, that fuck, you know, with Mo's in there. No way, I don't want to go to no house raver and hear Mo. House man are doing their nut. Trick. You had fucking Mo on a fucking house beat. They're doing their nut. It's like, you don't want to, I know what he's trying, bro. I respect it, but I don't feel more on there. You can't.
There's nothing wrong with experimenting, you know, like that. You get me? And no one.
There ain't, bro. But do it in the bedroom, bro.
I don't personally. This for me ain't my kind of music. And maybe because I'm a Mo fan, I'm being a bit biased. But this ain't shit. A man can't tell me this is shit.
No, I'm not saying.
Yeah, I'm not saying you're saying. I'm not saying you're saying this shit. I'm just saying this is one song that's different.
I don't think you can say it's not good.
I Mo, I'm gonna see Lippy week in week out. I'll let you know the next time he plays that song.
I let you know, bro.
He's never gonna
come
play.
On, lad. Listen, Tricky's wearing the garms for that kind of tune. You can't turn up in shorts and mint crepes, and then done off them tune there. Get out of here. You're set. That tune.
That should be your favourite song.
If Tricky's outfit was a tune, it'll be that tune. Am I right or wrong? Tell them. Mint trainers, cuz. Listen, get out of here. Put Tricky in the video, Mo. Put him in there. In that costume, there, sir. That's a wave, man. I'm not even cussing him. But he's there for the wave. Listen, put Tricky outside next to a pool. He's in that video. He's in that.
Oh, let me think, man, can't chat to me.
Like I said, Tricky come in a Garage Nation outfit and tried to not feel the Garage tune, but he wanna hear Gunman tune in mint trainers. I don't know what happened to them, man, there.
I don't rate this song.
I didn't really like this
song.
I think for me, it was one of the weaker songs on the album. No, personally, this song was probably the least resonating song for me on the album. And it wasn't just because it was a single and came out before the album. I don't know, it was just something that was just, I think it was maybe the chorus for me. And it was just a bit.
I don't know how Tricky could done off the tune before this, but rate this thing.
Yeah, what mess around with the gang, watch it click, click, bang.
You just want to hear a man getting shot.
They're going,
wow. He's on a nursery rhyme rhythm.
I understand it. Like,
he just wants to hear about WAPs. And all the men just want to hear about WAPs.
No, you know why? And I'm going to be honest with you. See, at the start of it, I was trying to put my finger on it. And he's just, I was like, he's got like that old school kind of Mace thing going on. Okay. Do you get what I'm saying? And he's brought it out on this song. You don't like this song?
You rocking with this?
Yeah, come forward and let Mo know you don't like it then, bro.
What? I'll let anyone know. I'm ready to skip this.
I'm not Mo.
I think it's well-rounded because the sound is consistent. If you put on the album and you listen to it as a whole, it flows. There's nothing that takes you too far out. Even when it gets kind of more commercial at the end with like the garage sounding song and then Wild and do what I wanna, wanna, when I wanna. Even with that, it still sounds like Mostack. He hasn't done anything that's just out of the ordinary and as if someone's, like, you know, a label's made him do it or something just for this project. So I think he's been true to himself and he's delivered. It's a big task. He could have called it a mixtape. He could have called it a project. He could have said EP. He's delivered on an album.
This is my tune. I think I lost my mind.
Let's go, come on, come on.
I don't think sometimes, I don't even know why. I just do what I wanna, what I wanna, what I wanna. Bang on.
Yes, man.
I just do what I wanna, what I wanna.
One sec, stop, stop, stop. Is it? One sec, stop. Is it just because it's popular or what? Because no tune that's played has got a response like this.
Because of the sample, like, yeah. it just resonates with you. It's just like, oh yeah, this reminds me of old school. Like, it's just nice. Yeah. Automatically nice.
Personally, I think it was a sick way for him to finish this. To finish the tape. Perfect. Because everyone likes to finish with, like, them sad songs. So you finish a hype album and at the end it's like, you want to cry? Do you get what I'm saying? He's leaving, you got, your vibes in. So the last thing you can remember is that track and you're like, you know what? Love Mo, giving him a 9.5. Do you get what I'm saying? Banger.
He done what he said on the tin, didn't he? If you like Mo Stacks and you know what to expect, that he gave you, like, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. You get me? He's got a formula and he stuck to it.
I'm going to give a 9. Because it's quality, you got the melodies and the raps and the summer feel. So yeah, 9 from me.
I'm gonna give it a 9.5 because I just wanna go higher. Yeah. I just wanna go higher. I just feel like this album was something that we rarely have, where it's like every song is, there's something about it. Nothing about it was shit. And I mean, I feel like he's been building up the anticipation for this album and it matched the anticipation. Well done, from the UK. Love it.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it an 8.5. I think it's a good album, I can dance to it. I only didn't like 2 songs really out of the whole 13, so that basically means it should be a 9, but I'm not gonna give it a 9 because me personally, I listen to a lot of like harder rap, so I didn't get that on there.
I'm gonna agree with Nash, I'm gonna go with the 9. Well, that's the first time I've heard it today. I would have skipped one tune. I can't say that about a lot of UK projects, you feel me? So that's big, 9 out of 10 minimum.
No, I would give it a 9 out of 10. I think it was a really, really, really good album. I think the production on every single song was incredible. Because I'm always under the impression that especially UK artists don't deliver good projects. I think this is probably one of the best projects.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
It's one of the best. Yeah, exactly. Because where everything bangs, you know you're doing something right. And I hope this goes number one.
I think it deserves a straight 10. Because what did I give? What did I give Dave? What did I give Dave? What did I give Dave? What did I give Dave?
I can't remember.
And I'm putting it out there. I think it was better than Dave's.
Definitely.
I know. Yeah, I'll say it. Don't worry about it. I'll say it. And okay, then cool. I'm giving him a 10 for the features alone. Every feature was a cold. You don't get cold body features. You know, everyone gets like a little Delroy down the road that no one knows. He didn't even come with that. Everyone is a dope ass Champions League. 10 out of 10 for a Champions League lineup. 10 out of 10 for flow and the things that he addressed and the way he addressed them. He gave us a dope album. Like you wouldn't want to skip a song. That Shine was probably the song I would say more not suited to me.
So, and there's nothing wrong with that. No, you can still give it a 10.
That gets you not killed.
You still give it a 10 and say that.
And it's still a 10. But I think for production wise as well, yeah. I think it's a straight 10, man. No flaws on that.
Yeah, I'm gonna give this a 8 out of 10. Solid 8 out of 10 for me personally. I like it. I think it's dope. There might be a little bit missing from it. Maybe like a little bit on the street side of things. There's a couple of little bit of grease. Yeah. There's a few men that might not be rocking with it. But like I said, most acts are called guilty pleasure for me. I like him. I feel what you're doing. And the lane that you're in, and I like it. So yeah, it was 8 out of 10 for me still.
Definitely give this a 9 out of 10. The first thing that stands out for me is the features, because that's what you're gonna see when you before you listen to it. It's a world-class album, in my opinion, for what it is. It's a good album. I don't think it's better than Dave's. For summertime, barbecue, pool parties, definitely, this is what it is. It is what it is. The only thing I don't really like about it is probably the Shine Girl song, but I like the album, it's got a story. So yeah, definitely, 9 out of 10. Shout out Mo Stack, man.
Look, 9 out of 10, we're giving it. Yeah, Mo Stack, Stacko, the album's out now, so make sure you go support that. UK music, the listening party, Link Up TV, big up everyone inside here as well. Enough jokes. Big up Rash, you know what it is. Aaron Roach, Richmond.